You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at BorisFX.com.
Here's a logo on a treadmill. And the problem with logos in your footage is a lot of times you can't get legal to approve them, so you got to get rid of them. Well, this is actually more of a complex remove than it looks like. You actually can't just move this data up here, because once this moves off screen, you don't have access to these pixels down here anymore to create a patch with, which is what I would normally do. And if you try to do just a straight up patch over the top of this, it won't look right, because the lighting actually changes quite a bit on this shot. It's subtle, but it's because the treadmill is bouncing around a lot. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a clean plate for this. So let's create this shot. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to launch Mocha, read this directly off my timeline. We're going to use translation, scale, rotation, shear, and perspective, and I'm going to make sure that I grab enough data that I'm going to get all of this information. And I'm going to track backwards. Now, notice that I didn't make a shape around the object that I wanted to remove first. That's because I can't see behind the object. So I might as well track all of the texture data that I can possibly get. So we're tracking the background first on this. I've included those two screws on the side, even though they're not technically on the same plane, because I want to anchor this as it goes off screen. All right, so there's my track for my remove. Let's do a quick test using our surface tool and check and make sure that this is glued to this object the whole time. That track looks nice and rock solid to me, which is good. We're going to call this BG, and I'm going to create a foreground shape for our little logo here. I'm going to take my shape and relax for some nice curves around the edges. And let's add some edge feathering as well. We're going to call this remove, and we're going to link it to track background. And you can see that follows and looks correct. Now we need to go to our remove module. So if I just hit render for this remove, I'm not going to remove the object. But what I can do is create a clean plate. And then I can use something like Silhouette, Photoshop, After Effects, whatever. I could use the GIMP, it doesn't matter. We're going to create a plate that doesn't have this logo. So all I'm going to do is take the healing brush tool, and I'm just going to heal that right out of here. Now, the reason I didn't use the clone tool is because if I take pixels from down here, they're darker than the pixels up here, because this actually tilts outward. So we just want to blend between all those pixels. I'm going to save this and close it. Click Use Clean Plates Exclusively. Turn my overlays off and hit Render Backwards. And that looks pretty good. But I do see a little bit of softness and lightness as this starts to go off screen. You can see where you can see the patch. I don't want that. So if I tried linear and tried rendering that, it looks okay, but I can still see a little bit of an edge. So we're going to try interpolate. And so now if I render this with interpolate, instead of raising the entire large shape in hue, saturation, and value based on an aggregate of the hue, saturation, and value around the object, we're actually looking at every point on the spline and doing a really complex blend. Now, I really don't recommend using interpolate if you have a long shot and you're doing a traditional remove, but if you're using a clean plate, interpolate can give you decently fast results, but the payoff is in how much time it saves you in color correcting your patch. Save and close. And again, we select remove in the dropdown and check the render checkbox. And now we have a flawless remove. And because I'm really picky, I would still probably degrain and regrain this shot to hide any sense, and especially to hide edge feathering. Now I'm going to show you what to do when you have serious, serious color changes.
You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects, and footage, purchase the premium version available at borisfx.com.